संधान ऑल गुजरात इंटीग्रेटेड क्लासरूम
सैटेलाइट ना माध्यम थी जोड़ती कड़ी एटले संधान।
गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, आई एम डॉक्टर नीवी चौधरी, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर फॉर इंग्लिश एंड सीसी। टुडे वी आर हियर टू स्टडी द टॉपिक नेटवर्क ऑफ कम्युनिकेशन इन द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन। Now, first of all, let's talk about communication. What is communication? Communication, it's all about to communicate with each other, to transfer your message to each other. Whatever is going on in your mind, we can share with each other. For that sake, we need communication. Now, in our day-to-day life, we used to do communicate with each other through face-to-face, through telephones, through emails, through letters, through WhatsApp, and so many other ways. Now, let's talk about how we can communicate in any organization or in any business. If we talk about business or organization, we need a proper channel. We need a proper way. We need a proper flow through which we can share our information from our colleagues, from our boss, from the clerk staff, and so many others. Thanks. Now, when we are talking about the network, we can say that there is a proper channel through which we can transfer our informations, our plannings, our projects in the surrounding of the communication. Now, today's topic is the network of communication in the organization. So let's start this lecture with a short PPT. Now, if we talk about the network of communication, in an organization, the information flows through the various channels and that creates a system. That system is communication network. Thus, communication network is a well-established system to communicate the message. For any organization, this network is very much important because through this network only we are able to transfer our proper message. What exactly we are trying to explain, we can show through this proper channel. For the success of any business or organization, this network is very much important. If the network or that channel is proper, we are able to transfer our message properly. So whatever the organization is planning, whatever that business network is planning, through that proper channel only we are able to proceed among all the staff members. Now, if we talk about an ideal network of communication, that ideal network of communication, through that only we are able to establish a proper administration. In short, if we want to run a proper administration, we need a proper channel. We need a proper network of the communication. Now, network of communication. What does it mean, network of communication? See, it's a bit different from the normal day-to-day life communication. In a normal day-to-day life communication, we are free to talk to anyone. We can share our views in a very free way. But as per as business or any organization is concerned, we need a proper channel through which we can transfer our message in a very proper way. And that is specially for the growth of any business. Now, in business organization, communication is what? Why do we need communication in any business organization? If you are running any company, is that much important? Yes, it is. If you are running any business or any organization, you need a proper channel for the communication. Why? It is all about the sharing the information between people within the organization. See, in any organization, so many people are there who are working with each other, who have so many things to share with each other, so many information, so many planning, so many projects. to share all those information with each other, we need a proper channel. That's it, we need this way that how we can communicate with each other. Now, it can also be defined as relying of information within a business. For business to transfer this information, these planning, these projects, these reports to each other, we need this communication. To run any organization properly, we need this proper channel. Now, a communication network refers how information flows within an organization. See, in any organization, that's a very much sure that we need communication. We need the proper way through which we can give orders to others, we can share our problems to others. But for that sake, we need a proper channel. And those information flows with a proper way. Now, if we are talking with anyone in a very normal way, suppose we are doing any face-to-face conversation with our friend, that communication will flow like this. Means up, down, and sometime straight. But if we talk about business communication, there is a proper flow. Flow in the sense upward, downward, horizontal. All those things we'll study in this network of communication. Now, information within an organization generally flow through a system. For those information, the system is very much important. Through that system only, we are able to adjust our information. Now, further, first of all, we'll understand the board of directors in any organization. If we are running any organization, there must be a board of directors. For that, we'll start from the managing director. Managing director, senior management, middle level management, senior supervisor, first line supervisor, and clerk and other workers. So if we talk about the board of directors, there are a proper channels. Through that channels only, those informations will flow. So to understand the flow in any organization, first of all, we must understand the board of directors. The board of directors in the sense that what are the different sections of any business or organization. Now further, there is one definition of communication network. It will help you to understand what exactly communication network is. Communication networks are regular pattern. It's a kind of pattern only. What kind of pattern? To that pattern of person-to-person relationship through which information flow in any organization. It's a method through which those information flows. As I told you, for any organization, why we need this network? This network is only that's a flow only through which we can share our information in any organization. For example, you are working somewhere in any company, right? And you are working there as a supervisor. Now you have something in your mind. You have some planning in your mind. How you will share that information through your boss. Now for that sake, you need communication. Now, maybe any clerk, he shared something with you, and being a supervisor, you should forward that information to your boss. Now clerk will share your information with you, and you will share that information from further manager. Now that's a flow of communication. Further, thus, it means that the flow of information flows in an organization. So there are so many informations regarding to our planning, information regarding to our project, information regarding to our problems, information regarding to other organization, our growth, all those information that flow with a different pattern. to understand those different pattern, we will understand what is communication network. Fine. Now this communication network, it may include two people, small group of people or large number. So it's not fixed that that network will stick with two people only or among that organization only. That network can be between two people, can be between a small group also, and it can be among the whole organization. So we typically find, a proper network. Now, let's start to understand the communication network. As I told you, for any communication network, there are so many flows. Sometime it's upward, sometime it's downward, sometime it's horizontal, and sometime it's grapevine. Now, in today's presentation, further, we'll try to understand all those flows. Now, first of all, I would like to explain you, the communication network can be formal also, can be informal also. Now, for example, if we are talking about a proper channel, if we have some problem, so being a junior staff, we'll share this problem with us, with a senior one, with a supervisor. Now, that supervisor will tell the problem to the manager. Now that manager will tell, now that manager will further transfer that information to the manager. Now there is a flow, there is a pattern, and that pattern is going upward. Now suppose the boss, he has an order, and that order he will tell to the junior one. The junior manager will transfer that order to the supervisor. The supervisor will convey that message to the other staff members. Now that is what, that information is coming from upward to downward. Now that flow from upper level to lower level is what? That is downward. So through this flow, we are able to describe this communication network in so many ways. Now, what is formal communication? Formal communication is what? It's planned by the organization. It's a planned one. It's not informal communication. Like we are, for example, we are talking to our friend. If we are talking to our friend, we do not need any planning. We do not need to think that what we are going to say. We just call him and we'll start with the conversation. That is what? That is informal conversation. But in business organization, we always do formal communication. And that communication will be planned by organization only. Now further, flows in all the direction. Those information will flow in all the direction. Sometime upward, sometime downward, sometime horizontal. Further, it's essential for the effective operation of the business. If we want to run our organization very effectively, this is very much important. If there is no proper channel, if there is no proper way, we are not able to run our organization properly. Further, now let's start with the formal communication network. What is formal communication network? It is one which is created by management. It is created by management. As I told you, it is organized by the organization only. It's created by the management and described with the help of an organizational chart. There is a chart, a proper way through you can decide that those information will go upward, downward or horizontal. Now what is upward communication? Upward communication is very simple. What is flows from subordinate position to superior position. It's going up from the down. It's going like this. For example, as I said, any clerk of any office, he has some problem. He'll tell that problem to the senior one. That senior one will convey that message to the manager. Now that is what? That is upward communication. Those information is going on an upper level from lower level. Lower level, say upper level ki taraf, if information is going, that is what? That is upper, that is upward communication. Now through this upward communication, what we can do? We can share our suggestions, we can share our problems, we can share our schemes, we can share our further information from our boss or from the upper level of the organization. Upward communication helps employees to express the requirement, the ideas and their feeling. See, if you are working in any organization and you are working in your lower level, maybe you have some problems, maybe you have some feelings, maybe you have some good ideas. Now those good ideas, your personal feelings, you want to share with your boss. And this upward communication will help you, this flow will help you to share your information with the senior one. And if you have that satisfaction during your work hours, that yes, if I have any problem, I can share that problem with my manager or with my boss, the system of organization will run properly, and that will help that will help to run your business very effectively. Now it is a flow of information from frontline employees to frontline employees. Means what? Those workers who are working on a lower level.